5-12-4 in the Mountain Valley Conference. So tonight we decide who will represent the Mountain Division in the MVC Championship game. Hi everyone, along with Bob Milkby, I'm Bob Capasso. Glad to have you along live in Curtis Gymnasium here at Stroudsburg for this one-game playoff to decide the Mountain champion, because these two teams have been so close all year and they're close tonight.
Jovan has his hands full.
On the other side, the Bears struggled last night. Their leading score
are going to be in for a treat, believe me. These two clubs have gone at each other in both their contests. Although the Cardinals have been victorious in both of those, they've been close all the way, and they've battled in each of those games. So you're going to see a good one tonight.
Game time is 7:40. The fans were here at 6 o'clock in line, waiting to get in when they opened the doors. The place was half full already at 6:30.
And what makes it great, you don't have the spaciousness of the Pocono Mountain Gym or the Pleasant Valley Bear Gym. These fans are right on the floor, and it's a packed house.
The first foul of the game goes against Arnold Allen. Pleasant Valley wearing the white, the home white. That by coin toss. Pocono Mountain in the road red. Pocono Mountain moving left to right on your screen. And Pleasant Valley right to left.
Both similar teams, defensively very quick. Watch for the Bears to trap any opportunity they can and take advantage of any turnover and get into that offensive transition game. You'll watch it there. There you saw it.
Matt Gould with the first steal of the game. He'll have plenty. Here's Matt in the corner for three. Got it! Matt Gould with his 22nd three-pointer off his 50th steal of the season. Gonzalez can't answer. And the rebound pulled away by Will Brown. Here's Gould again for another three. Allen inside gets the putback. The Bears have a good start.
And kind of evenly matched inside. So what you're going to see is desire. Who wants the ball more? An aggressive play for bounds.
Smalls to the hoop, picks up the foul. And that could be the second on Allen. Not something the Bears want. Allen working hard inside, 7.7 rebounds a game. You don't want him sitting on the bench. We saw that in last night's game with Palmerton. Jason DeWalt, their leading rebounder, their blue-collar guy inside, picked up two early fouls.
That really hurt him. Jason did not get on the board at all, and I think psychologically, too, him sitting early really hurt the Bombers. But Bob, talking to both coaches before the game, both teams are ready to play. This is a big one. This is the one that really counts. And I'll tell you, both teams are ready.
Gonzalez with the rebound, and Jamie Gould is called for his first personal. Will Brown is wearing number 31. Will Brown usually wears number 13. There's Brown having it knocked back away by Dillard. Here comes Jackson the other way. Jackson leans in and gets called for the offensive foul. Jamie Gould draws the charge.
And that's quickness against quickness. Cardinals turned it over and tried to come up quickly in their transition game. See it here. Gould holds his own. Good play defensively by Jamie.
By the Cardinals. Jackson on the defense. Here's Smalls. And Smalls will back it out. Gonzalez behind the back, quickly double covered, and he'll recover. He's going to get a lot of attention tonight. Jackson trying to force it in for Garcia. It's knocked out of bounds by both Wilson and Matt Gould.
We saw great help that time by the Bears defense. Is Adam Gonzalez. He'll penetrate on you, take that quick first step, but you see help defense come up on him immediately. He looked for the open man at the baseline, and he feels they're a little lax. Be more aggressive.
The other thing I noticed, even when we were down on the court, Bob, it is very warm in here. There is a large crowd Both these teams played an emotional full game last night, so we'll see if fatigue becomes a factor.
But when you're playing for the championship of a division, Bob, the honor of going in and playing for the league championship, you waive all that. When you're an athlete, that shouldn't make a difference.
Garcia will be called for the push-off. That allowed him to get that rebound. That's the first foul on Garcia and the second on the Cards.
You see it there, just aggressive play inside. Can't overdo it, though. Both teams emotionally filled up mentally here, and maybe over-aggressive early in this game.
Jackson picks up the foul. That's Darryl's second. For Pleasant Valley, Travis Kohler has come into the game. He's a 6'3 senior, number 20. Jackson will leave, and James Anderson comes into the game.
Kohler had a great game last night, 15 points coming off the bench. You know, some players respond better as sixth man. Others are starters, and they can't come off the bench. Kohler's one of those players that does well coming in as sixth man.
Looks like Jamie Gould needs a cut man down there. Jamie Gould has come out of the game, possibly a little bit of blood on his forehead. TJ Giannotti, who came up with 10 points on 3 3-pointers last night, is in the game. Here's Matt Gould, another chance at a three, and it's pulled away by Dillard, and Dillard will run for the Cards.
Here's a guy that controls it all offensively, having a good half year, latter half of the year for Coach Brad Pencil. That's Javon Smaltz. He's very impressed with Javon's play here of late.
The last time we saw Adam Gonzalez here, it was against Stroudsburg. He already had 10 points by this point. The Bears doing a very good job. Right now it's Matt Gould defending. Gonzalez in the lane. Gould is called for the foul. He thought he had all ball, but Matt picks up his first personal and the fourth on the Bears.
But what the Bears have to do defensively, they didn't do there. They really have to cheat from the weak side, really fall into the paint area to prevent penetration by a Gonzalez. He uses the screen well when he's got, Garcia in low, but Bob, he was isolated on that wing. You cannot leave him isolated. Help has to come over, way over to the paint to watch for his penetration. One man cannot guard man-to-man situation at Adam Gonzalez.
Adam, a 74% free throw shooter. He gets a pair, so 2 points for Adam Gonzalez. The Cardinals still without a field goal. Kohler for three. Rebound tipped up. Smalls had it for a moment. Kohler knocks it over to Will Brown. Giannotti in trouble. Here's Kohler with the step through.
Giannotti, good dish to get it to Kohler, but Kohler goes to the open spot. Giannotti was caught on the baseline. Couldn't get the ball to anyone, but Kohler's move into the paint freedom.
And Gonzalez traveled. Nearly half of the first quarter is gone, and Pocono Mountain has not gotten a field goal. Glad to have you all along, and I have a funny feeling we're going to start welcoming some of the people who couldn't make it into the gym tonight. Matt Gould for three. He's got another. A pair of three-pointers for Matt Gould, and the lead is up to seven.
The sophomore not feeling any pressure defensively from that Cardinal defense. He's open on the side. He feels it. He looks like he's shooting with confidence.
Giannotti's going to pick up the foul here. The Pleasant Valley fans wanted the push-off on Smalls. Giannotti picks up his first and already the fifth on Pleasant Valley. Pocono Mountain won the first meeting 67-59 and won last night 61-50. In the first game, Pleasant Valley got a big lead early on and the Cards were able to battle back.
Well, both teams so explosive offensively. Big leads in the beginning really with these two clubs. Doesn't mean a whole lot as it might in other games. These two teams can put the points on the board.
Smalls, the drive, the scoop shot. Garcia, and he's fouled by Will Brown. Brown picks up his first personal, and already the sixth on Pleasant Valley.
Yes, it's argued. Garcia, a junior, 6'3", does a good job for Brad Pencil coming off the bench. We saw him earlier this year, just workmanlike and very aggressive underneath the board. takes up a lot of space inside and is very aggressive. Kohler with the rebound. The winner will play Parkland Friday night at Parkland in the second half of the girls-boys doubleheader for the Mountain Valley Championship. Matt Gould again for three. This one is well off. It's Dillard with the rebound and the Cards run. Up ahead, Anderson, he can't hit, and the Cards are still without a field goal.
They got to finish. He heard the footsteps there. Anderson fell back a little bit on the layup.
Anderson and Matt Gould came together. Matt went down. Fans wanted a foul. Jamie Gould is back in as Matt will leave, and Matt will go see the paramedics right now.
And not an easy game to officiate. Two aggressive teams, and as quick as they are going to the ball, tough one to officiate out there.
Josh Rose is also in for Pocono Mountain, number 11, a 6'3 junior.
One thing the officials have to do, Bob, early is maintain control, and they do that by making calls early in the game.
Kohler gets the bounce and the roll, and the lead is 9. Smalls working against Gennady. Anderson in for Gonzalez, and Pocono Mountain finally has its first field goal.
Well, this is what we said pre-game. You've got to know where Adam Gonzalez is at all times. Moving well without the basketball this time. That's what makes Gonzalez so tough. He doesn't always do it off the dribble.
The answer at the other end is a three from Will Brown. His 26th of the season, and the lead is 10.
I'm going to ask for a better night to be warm. That is Coach Piankowski, and the Bears are warm tonight.
And then Jamie Gould knocks it off the leg of Jovan Small, so the Cards turn it over again.
Bob, this game looks like it's reversed. That is, the Cardinals beating them twice. It looks the way they're playing now. Looks like the Bears taking them twice. The Cardinals play a little tentative out there.
Kohler again. This one comes up short. Rose might have gotten a hand on it. Dillard with the rebound. Anderson for three. He can hit those and does. James Anderson is a 31% three-point shooter. He has 19 on the season now. And it's back to a 7-point game.
Besides looking for Gonzalez, they have to look for someone else to step it up. Anderson almost on the sideline there. What a bomb that was.
Wilson. Out for Jamie Gould. Gould off balance finds Brown, who finds Gould, who has it taken away by Dillard. And they're going to call it off of Jamie Gould.
One thing the Cardinal defense cannot allow Jamie Gould to do is penetrate. He likes to make that move into the paint. He's so quick with that move. It does most of his damage that way. You see him there. Once the defense plays him in that low, he makes the good dish. Cardinals fortunate defensively on that one.
Skip pass, Anderson for three. Rose with the rebound, and the foul is called on Jamie Gould. Jamie picks up his second. So the Bears here in the first quarter, despite having the lead, are getting themselves in foul trouble. Two on Gould, two on Allen, and 7 on the team already.
Yeah, this is what Coach Penzel has been looking for by inserting these players into the lineup off the bench. You see Rose there, strong underneath. At 6'3", gets up pretty good.
Brad Pencil have a headache.
Oh, we know Brad Logan. Does he look any different tonight than he did any other night? No way. Always in the game. Two great coaches tonight. Both great guys, great coaches. Coach Ken Piankowski for the Valley Bears, and Brad Pencil with Pocono Mountain Park.
Gonzalez slips in there off the miss and gets the putback. 6 points for Adam, and the lead is down to 5.
Matchup zone by these Cardinals.
Matt Gould for three off balance. Gonzalez with the rebound. The Bears back quickly on defense. Anderson, another try for three. Anderson with his second three-pointer, and all of a sudden it's a two-point game.
No question, Anderson has made his presence felt. You saw two people, that is two defenders, come up on Adam Gonzalez, double-team him, couldn't get the jumper, but a quick pass to the corner, and that's Anderson again.
in offense off the bench. 2 3-pointers. Pocono Mountain on an 8-0 run. Pleasant Valley went up 10 here in the first quarter. Wow, what an eventful first period this has been. Around at the buzzer, nearly gets it. And that's it for one.
You know, made an adjustment there on Matt Gould. He's hit a couple threes from that corner, but you saw the Pocono Mountain defense more aggressive coming out at him. But boy, what a game this is, and the Cardinals working their way back into it.
15-13 Bears after one. Out trouble over here. And we've only played one quarter.
You know, really strange, because they're playing a little scared that is the Cardinals early in the game. And I said, shouldn't be that way. Two wins, they should be opposite. But the Cardinals tentative early in the first quarter.
The Cards will open with the basketball. It'll be Dillard, Smalls, Gonzalez, Jackson with a bandage over his eye. Looks like a prize fight out there in Garcia, the starting five for Pocono Mountain. Don't look for Jackson to shoot a lot of threes. He's only one of five this season.
Little change up defensively for the Bears. Look at 2-3 zone. Opened up with man-to-man there. So quick, watch for the trap.
Matt Gould gets a hand on it.
Boy, just inviting the pass down to that corner about. That's a perfect trap area.
Gonzalez down for Garcia, and they're going to call him for the travel.
Again, good play by Adam Garcia, finding the seam in that zone, just finding the middle of the paint. Again, defense must play, and they stop ball as they must. Finds Garcia underneath, but he turns it over with the walk.
Kohler, nowhere to go with it, wow. So he puts up a three.
Why not? If you don't know where to pass the ball, why not shoot it? Kohler so effective from the perimeter. That time, I didn't think he had a prayer. Pressure defense was on him, but Kohler, nice mechanics over the top of the defense. Wow.
Blocking foul on the Bears. It goes against Will Wilson. That's his first. And the Bears are well over the limit. 8 fouls already.
Good call there. You see Wilson late getting to the baseline. Must establish yourself early on the baseline. Plant your foot right on the out-of-bounds line. No room at all when you're a defender, or else they're going to call a foul like they did there. Good call.
Front end of the 1-1. Missed. And it's going to be Pocono Mountain basketball.
Takes advantage of size mismatch with Gould and just power moves himself to the bucket.
Matt Gould pulls up for the 18-footer with a man right in his face. Matt Gould with 8 points already.
Well, they say they got to come out and play him tough. They are playing him tough, but again, like you said, Bob, Matt Gould over the top of the defense. Is he warm or what?
The lead is back up to 6. Jackson, double pump. Gonzalez, the putback. Adam Gonzalez all over the court. 8 points for Adam.
Well, I think you talk about Gonzalez's offensive ability putting points on the board, but I'll tell you, the kid works hard, does a great job rebound. Finds himself in great position.
The three for Will Wilson. Wilson's first basket of the night is a three, his 18th of the season. These Bears shoot well from outside. Dillard loses the handle. It's off Matt Gould. By the way, the Mountain Valley Conference All-Star team was named, and Adam Gonzalez was named the MVP.
Well, would you expect any other way? Well, you know what? You got some competition in there. You know those Parkland players? You got an Adam Lane and a Kevin Bassler.
Gonzalez with a chance for a 4-point play. He hits the three and is fouled by Matt Gould.
That's quite an honor for Matt to get that MVP award, but I'll tell you what, Bob, I could not see where he was. He was so far in the corner for that three, I'll see it better on the replay. You see him there, way beyond the three arc, almost out of bounds and way in the corner. How he made that one, I'll never know.
Adam Gonzalez and Liz Hayes, the MVPs. The boys' first team, Gonzalez, Adam Lane of Parkland, Kevin Batchelor of Parkland, Jamie Gould of Pleasant Valley, and Drew Chrisman of Whitehall. He can't complete the three-point play. Kohler saves the rebound, and Tanati will bring it up.
under there. He does such a good job. But Bob, I was saying, he's comfortable. You know, the ordinary player, you say, like, Gonzalez gets the ball way beyond the arc, should take a couple dribbles in, see the hard work there to penetrate that defense. But Adam will be comfortable outside. That's why he takes it from beyond the arc. An ordinary player, take a few dribbles in. A little shorter, a little more percentage type shot, but not with Adam.
Matt Gould has picked up his third personal foul.
This kid's kind of an underrated player in the shadows of an Adam Gonzalez. That is John Dillard, and the coach pencil depends on him so much contribute offensively, and particularly under the boards. Depends on him to hit the board strong, both ends, offensive and defense.
He's listed at 6'2".
Well, one thing, both these clubs are quick, both match up evenly size-wise, and what really maybe as they advance may hurt them, they don't have that really big guy inside in the paint that can kind of contribute from the low box area and help in the rebounding end.
John Dillard's listed at 6'2". I think he's 6'2" if he stands on that little extra piece of block board that the Cards bring from their home gym.
But doing a good job tonight already. Four boards for John Dillard.
And a lane violation on that free throw, so wave it off. Bears lead by 6 here in the second quarter. The winner plays Parkland. Doubleheader in Broadheadsville on Friday night. Here's a steal by Gonzalez to Smalls, and Smalls is fouled. The foul will go against Will Brown. That's his second.
Both clubs turn it around so quick in the transition. And talk about defense. You talk about offense. But Gonzalez made a great block there to get it up the court quickly. Boy, do they move.
The Cards might have had an argument for a goaltend there as well. There's Jovan Smalls. We'll have at least one team on the court on Friday. The girls will play Easton in the girls' championship, rematch of last year's final, game that went overtime. When Christine Rivori hit a three-pointer at the buzzer to send it to the extra section. Jamie Gould for 3. That comes off. It took an extra hop, and Will Wilson couldn't bring it down. He overjumped it. There's Jackson, and he's in trouble. Gonzalez thought about the 25-footer. Instead, he drives and can't finish. On the rebound, there's going to be a Cardinal foul.
Again, one-on-one situation with that kid there, number 50, Adam Gonzalez. He'll beat you every time, man. I don't care who you are. He's so quick, penetrates. A little weak on the finish there, a little short. But, Bob, what hurts the Pleasant Valley Bears in their lineup offensively, working the perimeter a lot, putting Kohler in the high post area occasionally, have Wilson working baseline, but they'll rotate and go to the perimeter too, so leaves them open as far as rebounding is concerned. No help, and the Cardinals in that matchup have a position underneath.
Knocked away by Garcia. Here's Smalls at the other end, and he'll have to pull it back out. Smalls, the crossover, the drive, the double pump, and he back rims it. Then he gets a steal, but he's whistled for the foul. Jovan Smalls picks up his first personal. The 5th on Pocono Mountain.
May have been clean, hard to tell from here. Quick hands by Jovan Smalls. Must have made contact. Official had the better angle on it.
Our officials tonight, Jack Kiter, who we saw last night in the Palmerton game, Dave Bundle and Steve Halluce. Wilson for Kohler. Thought about stepping in. Instead, he takes the 15-footer. And then Will Wilson tips it up and in.
Well, a big move by Wilson. Why? He was across the other side of the lane. Saw the bound off the iron and just moved aggressively to that position. And then a great touch on the tap.
The lead is back to 7. Gonzalez is fouled by Will Brown. That's his 3rd.
Well, don't
Don't expect Adam Gonzalez to be on the perimeter all night. Not Adam. He'll go in the low post when he feels he's comfortable there or finds a seam there. That time he takes the Pleasant Valley defense in low, picks up a foul. You must communicate defensively, know where this kid is at all times, and I'll tell you what, Bob, you don't play him one-on-one. You need help on an Adam Gonzalez.
He will shoot two. 12 points for Adam Gonzalez. Dillard is back as Rose leaves. Allen is back for PV, and we'll get a timeout here. It is a full timeout for Pleasant Valley. Bob, the Bears lead 28-22, but the foul situation continues to build for Pleasant Valley. Matt Gould and Will Brown with three each. Jamie Gould and Arnold Allen with two each.
Yeah, you know, Bob, this is the first half, and we said the game is played 32 minutes, and what you get in, when you get in foul trouble this early in the game, no question it could have effect as the game winds down, end of the third and the fourth quarter in particular. But to talk about Adam Gonzalez, does it all in this low post out of the perimeter. Play him as tough as I think they can play him, but need a little more help on him. He has three boards also, so he works hard underneath the boards too, not only an offensive player.
Just under 3 minutes left here in the second quarter, a jam-packed Curtis Gymnasium here at Stroudsburg. Pleasant Valley wrapped up the girls' Mountain Division title last night, final game of the regular season, by beating Pocono Mountain.
What rivalries the boys and the girls, both the basketball teams go at each other. The Pleasant Valley Club, as far as the girls are concerned, comes out on top, but both hard-fought contests in their games this year.
Yeah, what a year for this rivalry, too. All four teams playing great basketball. And what comebacks this season for the Pleasant Valley boys and the Pocono Mountain girls.
And just wondering, Bob, next year they split, of course, Pocono opening up their new high school, so there'll be two schools up that way. I wonder how much that will affect their athletic programs.
Jamie Gould is fouled. It'll go against Anderson. Well, it'll probably affect the boys more than the girls, at least initially, because from what I hear, all the starters, the underclass starters for the Pocono Mountain girls will be at the East School, the original Pocono Mountain School.
Jamie Gould on the line. You saw that replay. And what the Cardinals are failing to do on their defense, you see Coach Pencil deep in thought there, as he always is. I'd like to read his mind at this point. But the Gould does such a great job on penetrating. He will come the middle of the lane. This is where his forte is. This is what he looks for. And Cardinals failing to pick that up from Jamie.
Those are the first 2 points of the night for Jamie Gould, who averages over 15 a game. But everybody else has been picking up the slack. Here's Gonzalez off the nice dish from Anderson.
Anderson makes baseline, but boy, why is it defense around Gonzalez? You know you stop Anderson baseline in condition. Who was there again? Gonzalez in low.
Jamie Gould fouled by Anderson. So Anderson picks up his second. Anderson will leave, so will Garcia.
That's what happens when you allow baseline. A defender allows the offense to get baseline position. You come over on him late. Anderson way underneath, had no chance to make the goal. I would have just forced him, kept him underneath, but wisely dishes it to Gonzalez.
Gould 3-for-3 from the line. He's a 76% shooter.
Guy gets that deep baseline on you. You're a defender. You just belly up on him and keep him under there. Not going to do any damage that far underneath the board.
The lead back up to 8 for Pleasant Valley as we come down to the 2-minute mark in the second quarter. PV led by 10 in the first quarter. Pocono Mountain cut it to 2. PV with the steal, and Jamie Gould is fouled by Jovan Small, so Gould will go back to the line, and Smalls will receive his second personal foul.
Mistakes seem to compound when you get in this situation. You saw the play there. Dillard goes into a lot of traffic, a lot of white shirts. They love to pinch you and trap you there. No matter where you are, they'll double, triple team, and their quickness, that is the Bears. This is the strength of their defense. And, of course, Smalls trying to prevent the transition game, picks up the foul.
Jamie Gould, perfect in five attempts from the line.
Boy, talk about his career. What a great career he's had for the Bears. Jamie Gould, 5'10 senior.
Our male athlete of the fall season, fantastic soccer player. Jackson, Rose, now Gonzalez. Gonzalez will run down the left side of the lane and lean in. Gonzalez with 16.
Again, we'll mark the board. Where was he this time? High post. Good look inside. Falls off the post as the ball goes to the wing.
29 in the first meeting, 33 last night, and a projected 32 for Gonzalez tonight. 16 the first half. Jamie Gould up and down, looking for either the block or the foul, and he gets neither.
Yeah, what you don't do is not release the ball or leave your feet until you're sure you have someone to either a shot or have a player to pass the ball to. That time, Jamie's caught up in the air.
Randy Geek, a 6'2 senior, number 52, is in, and we have a backward violation on the card.
Boy, and I was wondering when they're going to call that, because it was close the last time. For some reason or other, Javon Smalls, a little late coming back, and they passed the ball over to him, and he just made it the last time. This time, failed to do it.
The Bears going to work a little clock here. At least try. Pocono Mountain extends to half court with the defense.
You got to watch underneath. I think Wilson open from the opposite side. Let's see if that comes to into play here.
Look for that open back door as somebody cheats up.
Watch the skip pass to Wilson.
Jackson whistled on the foul. That's his third.
Aggressive in extending that match up a defense. See the quickness of Gould. Boy, you're putting quickness against quickness. You have Smalls, Gould. Boy, Bob, there's all speed out there. Unbelievable.
Anderson back. Jackson leaves.
You know, it seems like Coach Pence is just looking for the right combination. Can't find the chemistry tonight with those five players out there.
All seven of those points, by the way, coming from the line for Jamie Gould. He is now 8 for 8 from the line. The lead is back to 10, and they're going to call a backcourt violation. And Jovan Smalls is arguing that Gennady had tipped it into the backcourt.
Yeah, very close, hard to tell. See if we can pick it up here. Gennady comes out to play Smalls. Ooh, boy. Reaches for the ball, but I don't know whether
it
got
it. I think it went off of Smalls' leg. I don't know if we can see that again.
Even
closely, we can see that, but it looked like it went off of Smalls' leg after Gennady had touched it.
Well, I can say one thing, Pocono Mountain fans, sitting right next to them. Let's try to look at it here. There's Gennady. He'll come out and play aggressive, and then, oh boy, I don't know. It's very hard to tell. Looks like maybe a hand got in there, but I couldn't tell for sure.
Under 10 here in the first half. Jamie Gould to the corner. Will Wilson for three. Got it!
No question. We had the ball before. I saw Wilson open in the corner. I thought they might look for him there. They did. He converted.
Bear fans on their feet. The largest lead of the game for Pleasant Valley takes them into the locker room at 13.
And I'll tell you what a difference from last night. The Bears only 15 points in that first half. Coach Biancasi said they were tight. They were playing their normal game. Tonight, they already have 39 on the board.
That's the way to end a half. 39-26. Pleasant Valley finishing the second quarter on an 11-4 run. They lead by 13.
Jamie.
Will Brown with three. Jamie Gould with two. Arnold Allen with two. On the other side, Daryl Jackson with three, and then two apiece on Smalls and Anderson.
But, Bob, they really have to tighten it up, that defense, that is as far as the Cardinals are concerned. A lot of less seams in that defense that the Bears were able to find in that first half. And this kid, bringing up the ball at his 50, needs help offensively.
Gonzalez pulls up for the three. That's one way to get back into
it. Does he need help? I think.
Well, hey, any range is Gonzalez's range. Huh? His 60th of the season and second on the night. And he is going to draw the foul on Jamie Gould. And then the two bump. And then Matt Gould bumps him. So a little bit of whooping going on the floor.
Hey, you got to love it, though. I mean, what competition out there. Great athletic ability.
But Jamie Gould has picked up his third personal.
A little trash talk going on out there.
Here's Jackson. Gonzalez thought about the 25-footer. Smalls.
Nice.
Dillard with the nice step through.
Boy, what they did, move Gonzalez to the point, have Smalls on the wing, and boy, underneath, just a great pass.
It's the two Goulds, the two Wills, and Allen in there for plus balance.
Gould squared, Will squared equals what? We'll find out.
Jamie Gould is fouled from behind by Javon Smalls. That's his third. Bob, I think the difference in this game may come down to the benches. With all these fouls, who's going to come off the bench and contribute?
No question, and you always find someone in these big games, and we say particularly in playoff situations, someone unexpectedly steps up.
Jamie Gould turns around. No defense was there. Dillard comes down with a rebound. Gonzalez pulls off another three.
And I'll tell you what, he got dunked by Brown after the shot. Gonzalez hit the floor, and what a shot that was. I mean, you couldn't play him any tighter. And are the Cardinals pumped? Wow.
So the Cards come out of the break with a quick 8-point run here, and quickly the Bears want a timeout. Adam Gonzalez, big from downtown.
And I'll tell you what, Gonzalez working hard. He has four boards now, and he's working that much harder in this second half. But Bob, the change to get the ball in the hands of Adam Gonzalez. Did he have it in his hands enough in the first half? Apparently, Coach Pencil didn't feel like he did, because now he has him at the point situation, at a point guard position. Why? He got his hands right up to that three-point arc, and man, he's looking at all iron every time he puts his hands on the ball in his second half. And why not? When you can hit one like this, he's downtown, and that's
Bob, did you see his eyes? He looked down, saw Will Wilson step over, and got a big smile on his face and said, ah, it's mine now.
And when he doesn't throw it from the perimeter, he's on penetrate defense, comes to him, dishes off. Good pass by Small to find Dillard underneath.
See if the Bears can answer here.
Game of momentum, basketball, and it's gone momentum-wise toward the Cardinals.
Will Brown answers for three.
And what can shut down that momentum is a big three, like you saw from Brown.
His second tray. The lead is back to eight. Gonzalez says,
does he feel it?
You can do it. I can do it.
Oh, Adam, the bomb.
They're playing horse out there. Gonzalez with the tip away. Smalls to the other end. Jovan goes end to end and lays it in.
Cardinals, momentum going their way. Smalls this time down the middle. Tough shot with the left hand.
It's a 13-3 run. Wilson gets his own rebound. And then it's Gonzalez with the bound. Adam thought about the three. This time drives. And before the shot, will pick up the fourth foul on Matt Gould.
Well, it's the Adam Gonzalez show, bringing the ball up again. Forget, he rebounded on the defensive end. Brings it up himself. Watch this. Gives that little pump and look at the bucket. Defense comes up on him, and he makes the quick move to the bucket. This kid is so tough to defend.
Inbound Smalls to Dillard, and Dillard will go to the line. The foul will go against TJ Giannotti, who has come back into the game. That's a good move there to find the open seam in the defense. Diller doing a good job for the Cardinals in that regard. Dillard with one more. Got it. It's a 13-3 run now for Pocono Mountain. You want your money's worth. You want to see a good scholastic game. You've got it here tonight. We expected it. Didn't look that way early, but boy.
Well, what a look from Brown to, or excuse me, from Wilson to Brown. Brown with 8 points. And that stops the Cardinal run. It was a 13-point lead at the half for PV. The Cards cut it to 1 moments ago. Smalls, Gennady defends. Will Brown defends on Gonzalez.
Well, interesting here. Bears go into man-to-man defense at this point, and Brown, as you said, playing at him.
Jackson misses the pull-up. Gennady with the rebound, and the Bears run. TJ tried to force it in to Wilson. It's knocked away by Garcia. Gonzalez comes to the front court. And he'll launch another three. This one comes off. He will get his own rebound and get fouled on the putback.
Well, follows his own fundamental in basketball. And Adam Gonzalez does it. Takes the long bomb, and boy, I just thought everything's going for this kid tonight, but not this one. Off the back of the iron, but hook who follows up his shot. That's Adam Gonzalez, goes up strong, power move, gets fouled. Kid's doing everything.
Kohler picks up his first personal, and the fourth on the Bears. Gonzalez with 10 points here in the third, and it's not halfway through. Of 7 from the line, and he has the Cards back within 1. Brown from the outside. Wilson's there for the putback and the foul. The whistle goes against Darryl Jackson, and that's his 4th.
It's the other Will inside. Will Brown shooting. Will Wilson inside. Been doing that all night, particularly in the first half. Has been a little quiet in the second half, but the kid's been working hard inside.
Wilson gets the bounce and the 3-point play. We are halfway through an entertaining 3rd quarter. Dillard, the turnaround. Comes up short, gets his own rebound, and gets the putback as he lands on his backside.
And all that is determination and aggressiveness. 3 white shirts in there. They failed to pick up the loose ball off the board. And who was it? Dillard on the miss, gets his own, puts it back. What work by John Dillard on that one. He has 6 boards tonight.
Jackson with the block of Kohler. There comes Gonzalez. A chance to tie. Adam. As it roll off, Garcia with the putback. Cesar Garcia, who got the start tonight, gets the big basket here, and we're tied at 47.
Boy, just a change in this second half. Momentum, Cardinals just so aggressive inside and just dominating the board.
Jamie Gould. Small's got a hand on it. Kohler recovers. Gonzalez gets a hand on that one, and it will go off of Pocono Mountain.
Well, not only does Adam score for you, rebounds for you, and he wanted to officiate that time. Points up the court, hope to steal one. Official says, Adam, I got it. It goes to the Bears.
He had 5 steals last night, along with 12 rebounds, and his 33 points. Gennady, and now Will Brown. Gennady for 3. He's a good 3-point shooter. Wilson had it for a moment. Dillard fights it away, but knocks it out of bounds.
Boy, a battling underneath. Did you see the bodies there? Dillard and Wilson underneath just going at each other. Watch it here. This thing comes off the iron. 2 bodies banging. One. Who wants it more? I'll tell you what, Bob,
position. They said height there. All these are factors in rebounding, but I'll tell you what. Desire. Who wants the ball more?
Kohler for three. And a foul inside off the ball whistled on Will Wilson, and that is just his second.
Let's watch it here. Wilson on the long bound makes body contact. Ball for the Cardinals. Why did he go through all that first quarter, second quarter? 47-47 as the third winds down. That's all passe. Why even play those first three quarters?
We got Gonzalez for the Cards' first lead. Dillard with the rebound, and he'll go to the line. And if that's Will Brown, that's his fourth. And it is.
Just more active underneath the boards in this second half. No question about it. The Cardinals, this kid here, doing a great job underneath. That's Dillard again. Boy, does he get the most out of 6'2".
Dillard with one more, and the first lead for Pocono Mount. Allen returns, Wilson leads for Pleasant Valley. Points for John Dillard, the first lead of the night for Pocono Mountain, 49-47, coming down to the two-minute mark in the third. Jamie Gould for three in the lead. And it's knocked out of bounds by Kohler off the rebound. Cards basketball.
Cardinal defense would prefer that Jamie Gould take that perimeter shot. He is a good perimeter shooter. However, his strength is in penetration. They've shut it down so far in this second half.
Taken away by Matt Gould, who's come back into the ball game, and that's a gutsy move. Four fouls on Matt Gould, and he's back in. Here's Jamie as it knocked away by Gonzalez. For three. Gonzalez fights away the rebound. Adam for the front court.
Matt Gould makes a stop on Gonzalez. I thought he lost the ball, but I think he dribbled right between his legs. Caught it right back, picked it up again.
Long three comes up short. Giannotti with the rebound. We're under a minute here in the third. Matt Gould, Kohler. Kohler, the drive, doesn't get the bounce. Allen with the rebound, and the foul from underneath is called on Dillard. That's only going to be the first on Dillard.
Well, let's watch it here. Penetration by Kohler. Defense comes over. Dillard with the contact.
Wow, good move. Matt Gould slipped in there and gets fouled by Gonzalez. Matt Gould just beat Gonzalez to the spot, and his brother found him on the inbound. Gonzalez picks up his first personal.
Well, I think they're a little asleep at the wheel. That is the Cardinals on an inbounds pass, and Matt Gould takes advantage of it with his quickness.
Here's Matt. All 8 points in the first half. Six on a pair of early three-pointers in the first quarter.
A little short there. Pulled back a little bit. Looks relaxed, however, with that deep breath. Just follow through a little more. You got it. There you go.
Pleasant Valley cuts it back to one with a half minute left in the third. Cards are going to look for the last shot.
as it is the Bears for these last 10 seconds. Who knows where this kid's gonna let it loose from, huh?
Wow. Adam with five, checks the clock, fakes the three, then puts up the three!
Oh, my goodness. I don't know what more you can say, because defense is playing Gonzalez all over the floor. They have a double team on him. He almost loses the ball there. Watch this. There's Gould up on him. Oh, he just, you think he throws it? Ah, he's got control of that thing. I'm telling you, Bob, it comes from the side. That was a hip shot over the shoulder. I said, no, the mechanics aren't there. It can't go. Does it go? No doubt about it. Is Gonzalez on fire? What a display tonight.
Cards by four after three.
Into this one. This is a more aggressive Cardinal team defensively and also under the boards in the second half, but offensively, it's still all Adam Gonzalez.
I think that V is rubbed off over there. It's supposed to say go PV, I guess. Cards with the basketball, cards in red, Bears in white. The winner plays Parkland Friday night in the Mountain Valley Championship game. Gonzalez goes baseline. Wow. He stepped on the baseline.
Well, he's certainly putting on a show tonight. This time he comes from the corner. Got too close to the line. In fact, on the line. So the Bears take over. Now, can momentum swing the other way? Cardinals had the answer for these Bears in this third quarter.
Allen runs down the miss. Here's Jamie Gould.
Momentum definitely favored the Cardinals, as we mentioned, but no sense in panicking or hurrying. The Bears, one whole quarter, a lot of minutes to play. But you don't do it that way by turning it over.
Gonzalez with the strip. Here's Diller.
Oh.
Inside for Cesar Garcia with the basket and the foul.
Well, Diller gets into the game, and you saw that beautiful no-look pass.
And Matt Gould has fouled out of the game.
Takes a lot of their offense away with Matt, such a good perimeter shooter. But boy, what a pass by Diller to find Garcia open underneath. Amazing how this momentum has changed in the second half.
The fifth foul on Matt Gould, so he is the first casualty.
Yeah, a lot of time left, too. Boy, you'd like to have Matty in there if your coach Ken Pianowski.
Will Brown has four, and Jamie Gould has three for Pleasant Valley. Jackson has four, Smalls has three for Pocono Mountain. And it's Garcia at the line for one. He completes the three-point play, and the Cards lead by seven.
Bob, we mentioned early, you know, foul trouble could make a difference. The Bears got into that early in this game.
Will Wilson is fouled by Dillard. That'll be only the second on John Dillard. The fifth on the Cards.
What they have to do offensively is really push the ball inside. Cardinals stop the penetration there, but pick up the foul. Good move by
Dillard with the block. But it will stay at this end
by Brown on that penetration the last time on the foul ball.
Giannotti for three. TJ Giannotti from downtown. His 35th of the season stops an 8-0 run, but Adam Gonzalez answers underneath for two at the other end.
How do you stop a player like Gonzalez? We tried to explain that pregame, but I asked Coach Thornton, is there a way you can stop him? We said try to contain him. I don't know if we can even do that.
Giannotti misses the long three. Smalls comes back the other way, goes to the floor, and is called for the travel.
Well, you sense it's a game of swings, a game of basketball, and the Mo may be changing at this point. The Bears getting back into it. Good job by Giannotti defensively that time.
Jamie Gould start to turn up the pressure on defense. Garcia, the spin move, doesn't get the bounce. Dillard, the putback, and he is fouled by, if that's Will Brown, that's his fifth. And it is the fifth on Will Brown. Boy, foul's now really taking its toll. Garcia, spin move in, falling back off the iron. But watch Dillard work. Three white shirts around him, bounce up, put back, picks up the foul. Matt Gould sitting there, and now Brown gonna find his spot on that bench. Kind of going out and giving all his teammates words of encouragement. Dillard with seven rebounds in this game, doing a workmanlike job underneath. Travis Kohler comes back into the game to replace Will Brown, who was fouled out. Brown is out, Gould is out, Matt Gould, that is, with fouls. They have been disqualified. Dillard hits the first. One of two. Jackson skies for the rebound, but misses the off-balance shot. Will Wilson with the rebound. It's a five-point lead for Pocono Mountain. Jamie Gould, the long three, he's got it. Jamie Gould with his first field goal of the night.
And that was from way out beyond the three-point arc. He can hit the perimeter shot. They shut him down on his penetration. He's looking for that perimeter shot.
17 three-pointers on the season. Jackson drives, and he's called for the offensive foul. Brad Pencil was trying to get a timeout. Jackson has fouled out of the game.
Pencil was looking for the timeout before Jackson made his move to the bucket and picked up that foul. But no one saw Coach Pencil with his T signaling there, and Jackson picks up the foul.
So Jackson leaves, and Brad Pencil trying to get a free timeout here. And he's going to talk to the guy who runs the show, Jovan Smalls. It's a two-point lead for Pleasant Valley. That was the seventh team foul on Pocono Mountain, a player control foul, however. So there are no free throws. Gennady with it. Will Wilson drives baseline. Too hard off the glass, but he'll run down his own rebound and then draw the third foul on Adam Gonzalez.
Well, you've got to like the work of Will Wilson on that play. Drives hard to the bucket, misses the shot. We'll see it here. Doesn't quit there. Keeps after the ball. Aggressive move. Picks it up in the near the corner, and Gonzalez makes the foul. But what hard, what great work by you. Willie Wilson.
That will send Wilson to the line. Wilson hit his only other attempt from the line tonight. But not the front end here, but Allen is there for the follow. We have another tie. Arnold Allen with the putback.
Kid's done good things tonight. Sneaks in there somehow, beats the red shirts to the ball.
Wilson nearly had the steal. Gonzalez double covered. Smalls backing it out. Dillard outside.
Wilson
and a steal by Jamie Gould. Gould with the steal. The foul at the other end. I thought he was going to get the roll. Jovan Smalls has picked up his fourth personal. And Jamie Gould will go to the line for the lead. He has been perfect in eight attempts from the line.
I'll tell have both teams so quick defensively. Jamie Gould, a great play, comes down strong. Smalls tries to plant himself in front of him. Gould makes the foul shot.
Gould hits the first, so the Bears retake the lead. He is 9 for 9 from the free throw line. Gould gives Pleasant Valley a 2-point lead with 4 minutes left, just under 4 minutes left here in the fourth quarter. The Bears led by 13 at the half. Pocono Mountain came back to take the lead in the third. And a timeout here by Pocono Mountain. Let's take a deep breath. 3:51 left in the fourth. Bears by 2. Pocono Mountain had a 13-3 run earlier. And a 12-3 run now for Pleasant Valley has given the Bears the lead.
Gonzalez a little quieter in this fourth quarter. Willie Wilson has the job man-to-man against Adam. He's out there now with him. And, wow, 3:51 left. Anybody's game.
Dillard, Smalls, Anderson, Gonzalez, and Garcia in there for Pocono Mountain. Wilson, Giannotti, Jamie Gould, Kohler, and Allen for Pleasant Valley. A near steal by Wilson. Here's Gonzalez who has it kicked away by Giannotti. Up ahead for Will Wilson. And he traveled.
Yeah, Wilson didn't put it down quick enough or go to the board fast enough. And I think it was a good call by the official.
Wilson agrees, by the way. He's saying, hey, you know, no argument.
Yeah, but see the help defense from Giannotti there to start the transition move by the Bears.
Gonzalez open in the corner. That comes out, and it's Giannotti with the rebound. Here comes TJ on the run. Makes a nice move, and then goes to the hoop. TJ Giannotti with 7, and the lead is up to 4. Gonzalez answers at the other end.
Boy, when a game gets down this, Gonzalez normally wants the ball, but he really wants it now in these situations.
Back and forth. The two arch rivals for the Mountain Division title. The winner plays Parkland in the second game Friday night. The first game will be the Pleasant Valley girls against Easton for the third time in 4 years. Kohler in the lane. Allen had the rebound, lost it. Gonzalez up with it. Adam to the front court. Adam makes a move. He goes to the hoop and is fouled by Kohler. Travis Kohler picks up his second personal.
And you see the aggressive move by Gonzalez. So hard to play him defensively. He just pushes it at you, and he'll continue. Very aggressive play. Kohler tries to come up on him, but Gonzalez just pushes it right down it.
Adam is 5 of 7 from the stripe.
Because this is 2:19 left. This is going to be some finish.
Adam Gonzalez ties it. Adam's season high, 42 points. Will Wilson gets the bounce for the lead.
Boy, is that a big goal. Hits the front of the iron, soft touch.
Gonzalez back for 3, and the Cards retake the lead. Adam Gonzalez answers from downtown.
You got it. I quit. I've seen enough. Back and forth. Wilson shot. Great shot in the paint, but this kid, look, knows where that three-point line is. Notice, didn't take, like, an inch away from the line, but knows exactly where it is, where to go up. Instead of taking the next dribble, two, he wants that 3. Wow. Well, what can you say? Fans getting a treat here at Stroudsburg, and all you fans at home, you're seeing some ball game.
Glad to have you along live here on TV 13. For those of you who couldn't get through the door,
7-4 run at this point. So, Bob, as you mentioned earlier, it is a game of swings going back and forth. Pocono Mountain Cardinals turn this time.
39 points, 6 three-pointers.
Is that what he has?
Gonzalez. 39. Like I said, he had 42. Oh. That's his season high. The Bears looking to retake the lead. Under 2 minutes left in the fourth. Jamie Gould goes to the floor. He was pushed. Anderson picks up the foul. James Anderson draws his third personal.
Anderson says, no way, I didn't touch him. And they see Gould on the floor. The foul is called. That puts Jamie on the line.
Well, Anderson had his hand on Jamie's back. Whether he really pushed him and helped him down or not, it's hard to tell. But when you have your hand back there, they're going to call you for the hand check, especially when the man goes down.
See his little mark of distinction there, that little butterfly tape job on his forehead. Jamie's been in the heat of action tonight.
And he ties the game up with his 11th straight free throw. And he gives the Bears the lead with his 12th. Smalls trying to stay away from the trap. Here's Dillard. Jovan outside.
The Bears go in that zone.
Gonzalez open for three. That comes off. Wilson with the rebound. Outlet, Jamie Gould. Hard bounce pass stolen by Gonzalez. He was looking for Kohler. Here comes Adam. On the crossover, the Bears looking for the travel or the double dribble. Anderson for three, and he's going to shoot three as he's fouled by Travis Kohler. That's the third on Kohler.
A nice look by Gonzalez. He's got two defenders around him. He sees Anderson open. Skip pass to Anderson. He's been effective from that distance earlier. But he's fouled by Kohler, comes up, tries to stop him on the three, makes contact after the stop.
Anderson ties it up at 66. And Ken Pienkowski wants a timeout. It is a full timeout with 1:11 left in the fourth. What a game it's been, Bob. The question was, could they come back with a lot of intensity after an emotional game last night? And the answer has been an overwhelming affirmative.
Absolutely. And we're seeing quite a display offensively with 39 points. That is Adam Gonzalez. He has six of those are three-pointers, and kid works hard under the boards also. He's got 8 boards in this game. So Adam not only doing it to it on the board, but boy, Bob, it comes down to 1-11 tie game, and we expected it, and as you said, you know, no tiredness in these kids. These are young athletes, and the intensity level, the emotional level out there, so high, and running on adrenaline.
While we have a chance, we're thinking of it in this emotional game. Kudos to Dave Beecher for the great stats tonight.
Right on top of things, Dave.
Right. His arm must be tired like mine is, counting Adam Gonzalez's numbers.
Not an easy job with these clubs moving up and down at the pace that they've set tonight.
James Anderson with 2 more after being fouled, taking a 3-point shot. This one for the lead comes up short.
Good look at Jim there, and there's the coach with the pencil again in his meditation.
Cardinals ahead with the second free throw. So he goes 2 of 3 from the line there, and it's a 1-point Cardinal lead. Jamie Gould, Travis Kohler, TJ Giannotti. Gould, the runner. No, Allen had it for a moment. Gonzalez takes it away.
I'll tell you what, all controlled by Allen, but last moment, Gonzalez just takes it away. Cardinals ball.
When do you foul? third. Remember, Matt Gould and Will Brown have fouled out of this game. Darryl Jackson has fouled out for Pocono Mountain. Dillard is 5 of 8 from the line.
Big foul shots here with 35 seconds left to play. You can imagine the tension. John Dillard on the line, 1 point lead. Dillard doing a good job. He's also working the boards hard with 7 tonight.
It's a 2 point lead and the Cards want a timeout. It is a full timeout. Let's take a breath. 35 seconds left in the fourth. 68-66 Cards. Division titleist, and will play Parkland Friday night in the Mountain Valley Championship game. Right now, Friday night, the last thing on anybody's mind.
And Bob, what do you do if you're Coach Pienkowski? Who do you work the play for? And I'll tell you what, they have balanced offense out there. You've got three kids that can hit the perimeter shot. You've got Jamie Gould, you got Gennady, and you have Travis Kohler. They all can hit that perimeter shot well. Are they going to look for the perimeter shot? I don't know. First order of business is get the ball up the floor. Get the ball in, get it up the floor without turning it over. Then I think you've got to watch Jamie Gould with penetration to the basket.
Gennady comes across. Half minute left. Gennady right to the hoop. Close it up, tie ball game.
Well, you saw penetration to the basket, but it wasn't Gould. It was Gennady. Big goal under a pressure circumstance. Wow.
It looks like the Cards are going to win it or tie it here. Gonzalez across. 14 seconds left in the fourth. Smalls. Now Gonzalez, 10. And Gonzalez is fouled by Will Wilson. That's his fourth personal, and they're going to put Gonzalez at the line.
Well, Wilson comes out aggressively on Gonzalez. Picks up the foul. Gonzalez likes that call because that puts him on the line with a tie game with 8 seconds to play.
And wow, it looks big now. The other thing that does too, Bob, is the Cardinals were going to go for a last shot. You got in Gonzalez's hands. You got to love that if you're the Cards. So what does Pleasant Valley do? Makes him shoot it earlier. One more for Adam Gonzalez in the lead. He gets the second. And a timeout. Adam Gonzalez stole the inbound pass. Pocono Mountain had called a timeout.
Well, you know, you got 7 seconds left on the clock. That is the Bears. They've got to go full length of the court. Normally, that's a good amount of time to get it up court. But in order to get it up court and still get your percentage shot, it's going to be a little difficult. I see they put 8 on the clock now instead of the 7. Added a second to that. And a tense situation for Ken Pienkowski. They've got to get the ball up quickly, but if there's pressure here by the Cardinals, and I think you're going to see pressure to try to hinder the inbound pass, make it tough for them to bring it in. The Bears have to respond quickly, and boy, fans going wild here.
That was the one by Gennady to tie it. The free throw by Gonzalez puts Pocono Mountain ahead 69-68. It'll be Jamie Gould to trigger. He can run the baseline.
Well, not pressure on the pass in. They're going to let Gould bring it in. The pressure is going to come after the pass is caught. This giving the Cardinals an extra defensive player on the far end of the court.
Here comes Gennady. The clock's at 5. Gennady behind the back. The drive for the win. Blocked from behind. It was Anderson on the block. Garcia on the rebound. And the Cardinals have won a thriller.
Well, the Bears had enough time. Broke the pressure of the Cardinals, but of course they didn't want a foul in the last few seconds. Gennady with the good move into the paint, looked like he had the shot, but from behind, the long outstretched hand of a Jim Anderson knocks it away. There you see a jubilant Adam Gonzalez as the Cardinals win it, their third over the Bears this year.
The block from behind by Anderson, the big rebound by Garcia ends it.
It's one of those, it's the cliche again, Bob, but as hard as these two clubs play, it is again a shame anyone has to lose a game of this intensity. And of course, the Cardinals pick up another win, and they'll face those mighty Parkland Trojans in the Mountain Valley Championship.
Wow. What a ball game. The Cardinals win it by 169-68 on an Adam Gonzalez free throw, and then a James Anderson block of TJ Giannotti on a last second try. And the Cardinals will play undefeated Parkland for the title on Friday night. The fans still on their feet here at Stroudsburg.
Well, I think a tribute to both clubs in a hard-fought contest. Game of swings went back and forth. Cardinals winning it. Coach Batsinger, the Trojans here tonight, got an eyeful, and of course, pretty familiar with this Cardinal club, and especially familiar with an Adam Gonzalez. So, you know, that's certainly a tough club and an undefeated club. So the Cardinals have their hands full in that championship game.
The final score here is Pocono Mountain 69, Pleasant Valley 68. We're going to corral the Cardinals and be back to talk with the victors in just a moment. Stay with us. Pocono Mountain beats Pleasant Valley 69-68 in the 25th game of the season. An MVC Mountain Division playoff to see who moves on to play Parkland on Friday night. And it will be Pocono Mountain once again. Here are the leading scorers in that 40. That's no misprint. 40 points for Adam Gonzalez. The one big one at the end. He missed the first of the two free throws, then hit the second before TJ Giannotti went down court for a last second try. Dillard with 12. How about Anderson? Off the bench, James Anderson with 8 points, and he was the man who had the block at the end to preserve the victory. Garcia with 5. Huge, huge points in the start for Caesar, and Jobon Smalls with 4. Jamie Gould went 12 for 12 from the free throw line and finished with 15 points. Right now, let's go down to Bob Milkvy.
Coach Brad Pensel, Pocono Mountain Cardinals, victorious in quite a game, Brad, here at Stroudsburg. This is your third win. We were saying, can a team beat another team 3 times in 1 year?
Very difficult to do. Pleasant Valley's an excellent team. We knew we'd have our hands full, but, you know, we did what we had to do. First half, I thought we played selfishly, one-on-one stuff. Second half, I thought we played as a team, and I thought that was the difference.
Yeah, it's a game of swings. I think we were a little tentative that first half defense really picked it up the second.
Well, we did a little better job pressuring the perimeter shooters. I thought they shot the ball real well the first half. Second half, we extended a little bit, so we get some hands up on people, and I thought that was the difference.
And coming up game, championship game, you'd love to be there. I know you want another shot at the Trojans. You're going to get it.
And we're glad to be there. We think we should be there. I think our kids deserve to be there. And I'm not just happy to be there. I think we're gonna, represent the division real well.
Well, good luck in that game on Friday, Brad. I know a lot of people waiting for you. Congratulations, great ball game.
Thanks, Bob.
Good luck to you. Adam Gonzalez. Adam, I don't know how many points you had tonight, but you had 40 big ones. What an offensive performance.
Yeah, we came down in the first half and we didn't really play that good. We let them shoot around them. Last night we kind of walked all over them, so we knew tonight they was coming to play. So they played real good in the first half, and the second half we just came out and played.
Yeah, what happened in the first half? A little tentative, didn't play real tough defensively, kind of let the Bears get off on you big.
Yeah, last night we played real tough defense, and they just wasn't knocking down shots like that. Tonight they knocked down a lot of shots, so we went in the locker room at halftime, and Coach said, you just got to play tighter defense and step up on offense.
And let me ask you, Adam, I've seen you throw some bombs all year, threw some big ones tonight. I don't know how many threes you had. You had 40 points, however, but what is your range? Can you tell me?
I really don't know. I just let it go.
Well, Well, Adam, great job, and you're going to have a tough one on Friday. What are your thoughts on the Trojans?
I just think we got to come into Parkland. It's going to be tough playing at Parkland, and we just got to play our game, play as a team. We can't play individually.
Well, a great game for you, Adam. Good luck in that championship game. Well, you heard Coach Brad Pencil. You heard terrific offensive performance by an Adam Gonzalez. And what more can you say? 40 points, Bob. But they have a big one coming up on Friday. The Parkland Trojans undefeated. But I think your Pocono Mountain Cardinals are ready. Back to you, Bob.
Thanks, Bob.
Adam Gonzalez's ability as a basketball player, I'm pretty sure they've been answered. Big players come up big in big games, so after last night's performance against Pleasant Valley, maybe we should start calling him Adam the Giant. Gonzalez hit the 40-point mark against Pleasant Valley, including the game-winning free throw to give the Cardinals their second straight MVC Mountain Division Championship. We go to Curtis Gymnasium in Stroudsburg. Second quarter, Bears up by 10. Jamie Gould to Will Wilson for three. Pleasant Valley led 39-26 at the break. Third quarter, Gonzalez misses on the drive, but Cesar Garcia follows. Game tied at 47. Cardinals outscored the Bears 26-9 in the third. Fourth quarter, a seesaw battle most of the way. Pleasant Valley up 64-62. Gonzalez hits one of his eight trays on the night. Pocono Mountain up by one. Then with time running down, Cards up 68-66. TJ Giannotti hits the floater, game tied at 68. But then Will Wilson would foul Gonzalez with 8 seconds left, sending Adam to the line. He hits one of two to make it 69-68. Pleasant Valley then going for the win. TJ Giannotti appears to have a good look, but in slow motion, you can see James Anderson get a piece of the ball from behind. Bedlam, Pocono Mountain wins it. 69-68, earning the Cardinals a berth in the MVC Championship game against Parkland.
Valley Wednesday night, 69-68. Parkland unbeaten, 24-0, 16-0 in the Mountain Valley Conference. Their last game, they beat Easton 65-54 on Tuesday.
Doesn't happen too often. Anybody goes undefeated for a season. I think the last Lehigh Valley team or the area team that had done it was 1992 or 93, Salisbury, when they had Antoine Hubbard. So a long time coming. You have an undefeated team, and the Cardinals want to end that right here.
Pocono Mountain will wear red, and Parkland will wear white. Cardinals open with the basketball. No confusion this year. They made it very clear who was the home team and who was the visitors. Adam Gonzalez trying to make the move. Here's Jackson. Jackson on the drive, and it's Adam Lane with the rebound.
And how much can you say about an Adam Lane? So consistent, such a solid player out there.
Inside, Bassler, well, we said he's not only a three-point shooter, there he is, a 52% field goal shooter, Kevin Bassler.
A smart player, Bob. Why? Perimeter wing-type player. Sees the opening in that defense, goes right to the open spot.
Gonzalez drops it off for Dillard. Great-looking play from Gonzalez to Dillard. Adam averages three assists a game.
Yeah, you see the attention he draws when he hits the paint and that penetration. Finds the open man.
Here's Olsen, won't shoot a lot of threes, just 3 of 10. This guy will, Bassler. Olsen goes baseline, tries to dish it inside. Little, it's stolen by Pocono Mountain.
Now you don't have to be too concerned of Eddie Olsen's perimeter shooting. He's gonna look to penetrate or dish.
Dillard is fouled by Robert Little. It's the first foul of the game.
Good move there to get pick up the foul on Little there. You see 6'8", Robert Little. Attacking 41, John Dillard. He's done such a good job at 6'2", really gets up strong, has done yeoman-like work for Brad Pencil's Cardinals this year under the board.
one of two. Lane with the rebound. Adam Lane, 16.8 points and 8 rebounds a game. Batchelor loses it out of bounds. The Cardinals will get it back. Remember, the Cardinals jumped out to a big lead in the first half of their meeting back on the 25th of January before Parkland came back late in the first half and won it 75-61. Jackson off the screen. Here's Gonzalez. The fake, the drive, and the basket. Adam Gonzalez averaging 28.5 points per game.
He really has not had good games, his normal games against these Trojans each time he's faced them. And boy, he is a determined Adam Gonzalez tonight.
Adam comes off a 13 rebound game. 40 points, 13 rebounds, 6 three-pointers, 5 steals, and the playoff win against Pleasant Valley. There's Huber. He can shoot the three. He's a 42% three-point shooter.
Well, you see the matchup defense. When Olsen goes out to the point, they're really packing it down in the paint. Good scouting report. Olsen doesn't like to take the shot from the perimeter.
Little inside, knocked away by Jackson. Here comes Gonzalez. It's a 4-on-1. Gonzalez to Smalls, back to Gonzalez. And right back the other way. Parkland misses on the layup try. Batchelor the put back, no. Lane the tip up, no. Loose ball, and it's Jackson with the rebound. Cards run again. 3-on-1. Right side for John Dillard.
Boy, great move by Jovan Smalls. They had numbers, but spacing was perfect. They ran that tradition to a team.
At the other end, the basket with a lid on it for Parkland, and Parkland loses it out of bounds.
Now, what they're doing when they pack it in and giving Olsen that room, a lot of help against Little and Lane and Low. So when they pack it in, boy, they can double, triple team anytime Little or Lane get the ball in the